Good evening, the internet. Welcome back to Tequin TV. Today we're pleased to bring you a new series called Crappypasta. It's the scariest stories in gaming that aren't scary. Today we have a story from gaming's own elephant graveyard, World of Tanks. So one day, I logged into World of Tanks to see that someone sent a friend request to me. I looked at it, and the friend request was from a 53%er who wanted to platoon. I will not give his name for naming and shaming reasons. How dare a lowly 53%er not slather his face and get good grease? He seemed pretty cool, so I accepted the request. I asked him what tier, and he said tier 10. I said I only have a tier 9. We platooned a couple of games at tier 8, because he had sold all of his tier 9s. In the middle of one game, I noticed something. Dot, dot, dot. The enemy team seemed to avoid him. Dot, dot, dot. Yeah, they shot at him and fought him, only if they had to. Dot, dot, dot. I also noticed our own team went opposite ways from him. After a couple more games, I asked him how long he has played this game. Dot, dot, dot. He said he started a couple years ago. Then in the middle of one game, he said, "Look out behind me." Dot, dot, dot. I turned my tank around because I didn't have a turret or a third-person camera. I turned my tank around and there was no one there. Then he said, dot, dot, dot. "No in real life." I turned around and saw the scariest thing ever. Dot, dot, dot. I saw a man in what seemed like a World War II uniform. The man saluted me and disappeared. It was then that I realized I wasn't sure what type of World War II uniform he was wearing. I was spooked and asked him, how did he do that? My tank in-game was destroyed, and I was in garage. The platoon had been dismissed. I reported him via support ticket, but all I got back was this, semicolon. The player you mentioned does not exist. And that was it. I messaged the guy and said, "Hey, what happened?" Dot, dot, dot. No response. Dot, dot, dot. I made a post on the forums, and it was immediately taken down. One of the Wargaming staff members telling me, "I would not make any more posts on the subject if I were you. I would not let this stop me." I did some searching in community bases outside of Wargaming's control. And I found out something chilling. The man I saw was a World War II tank commander who died when his M4 Sherman was hit by a Panzer VI Tiger I. I also found out that his commander's spirit resided in Watt. Dot, dot, dot. I will come back with more info and possibly picture sightings of the man. Dot, dot, dot. Wish me luck. So at this point, I'd like to read one of the responses that was made to him and the response to that guy. So this guy says, and this is a valid point, he says, "That can't be true. American tankers only encountered tigers 3 times. The first time, the Shermans destroyed a cornered tiger. The second time, a retreating Pershing was destroyed. The third time, tigers were being loaded into train cars, so it wasn't really a fair fight. No Shermans were ever destroyed by tigers." Which sounds a little pompous, but to the best of my knowledge, I don't think he's wrong. And another guy replies and says, "So what about the time when Fury destroyed the tiger? That should be 4 instances. To which I have to point out that that's a movie. Not real. It was a real war. Brad Pitt wasn't actually there. So probably check that out before you go stating films as historical accuracy. So that's today's Crappypasta. Thanks you guys for tuning in. We'll see you next time.